Hi. I thought you'd be home late.
Mithini usiphithibela ka tello. Re finitse ele. Tsatsi la ho lebele le ba.
Fine. It was nice and relaxing.
Good. Good. Glad to see you feeling better.
With my teeth in deep first time round, you know?
Because I think that was the hugest. For starters,
it was a very big role. It was a very big role. But it was enjoyable. I loved every minute of it. And I think that's why to this day, many people will still remember her and many people will still hold her dear, you know? Because she was just so memorable. She was just in a world of her own. She was just, you know.
Not only are we here to chat with you, but we're even much because today, you are the day shooting your music video.
Yeah, sure.
Quite exhausting.
Very. I'm so tired. I'm finished right now. I never actually wear like sunglasses for anything, but
your eyes are gone.
I'm finished. My voice is finished. So yeah.
Well, it's okay. At least we still have you.
But it was worth it. It was worth it.
Hey. Yeah. Before we get into that particular business, tell me a little bit about Psyfo. Who is Psyfo? Where does he come from? When did he tap into what he's into now?
I'm from a very small town in South Africa called, rather in the Northern Cape within South Africa. It's called Kimberley. Mm-hmm. A lot of people obviously wouldn't know of the town because of its famous history being into diamonds and so on, and De Beers. And, but I was born in Kimberley. My whole family is based in Kimberley, but I've got family all around South Africa. I was raised in like three different cities in South Africa, obviously Kimberley being one of them, Cape Town being a huge influence in my upbringing as I was entering my teens, you know, and moving to Joburg in my teens. So I kind of like all, I'd say the three biggest stages in my life happened down south. And when I got to Joburg, it was kind of like a thing of me now starting to explore and trying to find myself, you
finding
know?
You
and somehow bumped into this crazy industry, the entertainment industry. And at first it was a thing of just, it was just luck, really, you know. I always say this, but it really was a thing of me being at the right place at the right time
and God's purpose,
you know what I'm saying? I'd look at it as the universe communicating to me, you know. That's God for me, it's the universe, and the universe has a plan for all of us. And my plan was really to entertain people, and I believe, and to make people happy, and that really makes me happy to see other people being happy and spreading positive energies. I'm just one of those people. I never like giving people negative energies because I believe in karma. You know, the universe is a way of bringing that back to you. So if I meet someone for the first time in the street, it really is a thing of me saying, "Hey, what's up, friend?"
Yeah,
you know. And giving you the benefit of the doubt.
Exactly.
And it's really up
being
to you.
Being you, just relating to people as they are.
For sure. And it's up to you to mess that up, you know. And, and that's so I always trust people. I never, there's never a moment where I'm like, when
you're
I meet
cynical.
You for the first time, I'm like, unless my energy is telling me that this is a very shady character, you know.
Well, we definitely should trust our energies or our instinct or something.
For sure.
But now you got into the television industry now very, very young. I can recall you back then. That's when the name Psyfo was very popular. That was before Psyfo.
Sure.
You were with your TV. I think you were you basically grew up in the entertainment, in television rather. Mm-hmm. Tell me about how you exactly ended up tapping into television. Because you've come to grow within it as a young person, your teenager, and then now you're a young adult, still in the industry and growing stronger.
Like I said at the beginning, it was just luck, really. But then I grew to love it, you know. Because it was, in a way, the universe telling me this is where you were supposed to be. And like every day I'd go to work and, it wasn't work at then, you know. Back then it was just a thing of, I like what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Although I was earning a salary, but it wasn't really about the money, you know.
It was the love.
When I left high school, in fact, when I was doing my trick, and where you now have to make a decision on what you want to do for the rest of your life, that I was like, you know what? I like what I'm doing. In fact, I love it. And I'm getting paid for it. So why don't I just continue doing what I do and make a living out of it? And that's how I started developing my brand. At first, it wasn't a conscious decision. It just came that I was just this clean person.
This is the situation. The cold product operation been decimating some local and foreign radio stations. We know that you've been patiently waiting, anticipating the culmination of our post-premier compilation. Well, here it is. Ladder, judge you up a puff and say, pull your glass up. Move to the rhythm, handle your biz, shake that ass up. Talking to women with thick figures and curves and getting wine and dines, what they prefer. Damn it, we back at it again. Y'all know what it is. The wolf's loose in the chicken coop yet again. We here to flip the script, click, keeping it real. Redefining the street lingo definition of ill. Cause we're the type to roll up on you while you on your corner with all your homies ever warning and snipe ya. It's alright though, I try to be nice. So here's a bootleg for half the price, but just keep it on the hush. Don't even call 5-0 when we convo your robots. No, you better keep it on the hush. Before these black folks stop ya, you can't say you ain't been wrong, but just keep it on the hush.
We had to come with that one track, that one track that have that bass drum saying take that. That track to blast, make everybody get back. So spectacular, we had to keep it on up. Hey, but we ain't take too long, yeah. We had to come through strong, you know, break a few bones. We got kids reaching for ones, wishing they was home, chilling with moms. Try to keep it on up. And the beat goes on, yeah. Let the beat go on, and the beat goes, hey. Let the beat go on, cause that flow hit too damn strong. So it won't be wrong for you to grab a waistline and dance. Raise up your weight, don't waste time with glance. It takes the same weather in a bottle of can. And we don't mind if you call us a gang, but just
don't even call 5-0 when we convo your whole by slow. You better keep it on up. Before these black bulls stop ya, you can't say you ain't been wrong, but just keep it on up. So zip your face up, don't let nobody hear about it, keep your mouth shut. Chitter chatter, only get your finger band up. I know it ain't the way you want it all to end up. So just keep it on the hush. Don't even call 5-0 when we come for your whole blast. No, you
better. Yes, 8 seconds.
Until you pass out?
No, off my average time. I want to send you to
No, save your breath. It looks like you're running low.
Yeah, I've been listening to sprint up 4th Avenue. Got me straight dog out of nowhere.
Oh, and outrunning a straight sprint, impressive. Yeah, one more now. You're going to start making us old men look bad.
Hey, how about you fall?
I because I've been swimming before. I lunch on Palace's orders. I'm actually proud of myself for Glala, not for missing Tena. Which reminds me, Gladys, when I carry powder in a tomato period.
Now from the real,
exactly.
But at the same time, yeah. I think that's the one thing that you have in common. But tell me, since you've been on Generations for how many years now?
About it's been since 2007.
Yeah.
So yeah, about 2 years.
Yeah. And tell me about the world of soapies. When somebody's out there, they just see the clothes, that llama. Oof. You always look stunning. I mean, I'm looking at you. I'm thinking, when I leave, I'm leaving with those shoes. I'm not sure what size you are, but I love them. You're always up to date.
Thank you. What? You work the whole day till 7 o'clock at night.
Sometimes
you know.
Later.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. You pull in like 12-hour, 13-hour shifts. Mm-hmm. It's not easy, mm-hmm. and you still have to look fabulous and be friendly and. Get going and remember all your lines and all the director's moves and everything at the same time. So it's not as wonderful as people make it out. We enjoy it because it's what we do. Mm-hmm. We enjoy it because it's who we are.
Exactly.
Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I find peace doing what I do because it forms a part of who I am.
Yeah.
Every time, all the time.
Oh, I'm gonna hook up with some freebies, you know, like a new MP4 player.
If Baka decided to sponsor launch, I could try wangle it.
Awesome. Thinking about you'd finalize the sponsors like ages ago.
Matsarina go hong karaba. Ke santsane ke metse confirmation ya venue pele ka finalize dilo.
Ba phone le ke boss lady because tsaranang is in.
Samuel gana go thata ka so.
Totally. Yes, unbuzile kuba one ngacela nga yena in the first place.
Really?
Yeah. Yes, ba phone ngcwe to organize and everything.
That's fine. Ke tla khona. Aska tshwenye.
No. The policy ya tsaranang le, you know, ba be host a function. These guys they help out, you know, catering, lights, AV equipment, the works. So yeah, into ya bole.
What was that? Fella.
Fella in Don.
Nale Samuel, history aron. I hike batle gore ane uncomfortable.
Ga soze, na ga ncinci. You know what? He's really looking forward to this.
O bile jan.
Pretty much.
Oh well, if he's fine with it, so am I.
Hello to you great and awesome people of the rich soil of Africa. Welcome to another exciting episode of Soul Screen Profiles, where we are focusing on actors and actresses within South Africa and all over Africa. Tonight we are no different. We are excitedly again still on Generations, South Africa's most loved soap is on SABC1, and we are doubling up with Ajax. You may call him Psyfo, others call him Psyfo. Well, he's got many names because surely he's a young boy, a young man rather, of many talents. He's shooting his latest music video. He's also one of Generations stars. After this, we're going to get to know better. Is that Psyfo who is real? Is it Ajax who is real? Well, that's why Soul Screen is here, for you to know the difference between the real life character and the television character. Stay tuned. Well, here I am finally seated with Psyfo, a young man called Psyfo. He's called Ajax, but right after this interview, you'll agree with me. Psyfo and Ajax are two different people, but I'll leave it to you to judge for yourself. Psyfo, welcome.
How are you doing?
Good, thanks.
Thanks. Thank you very much for having me on the show.
We are honored to be here.
Like I said, I'm just like positive energy.
Yeah.
I'm not saying like I'm a perfect human being.
Of course.
I'll make mistakes, but in anything that I do, I try and be responsible, you know, most of the time. I try and, because I was raised up in a family where my mom trusted me. She gave me the benefit of the doubt in that she was like, you know, if you go out with your friends, go out and have fun, but just do it in the proper way.
And that's she allowed you to be you, yeah, and that developed
because she trusted me.
Yeah.
And she gave me that. I didn't want to disappoint her, you know, so therefore I was raised on those morals of giving trust and just being responsible. And I was also made very, I was made independent from a very, very young age.
Lovely.
My mom gave me, like when I started earning a salary, she's like, you know what, that's your money. Mm-hmm. You're going to do what you want to do with it. So I'm going to open up a bank account for you on my name, and you're going to take care of it for yourself. So I had my own bank card as a 12-year-old kid, and I was drawing money out of it, and I was doing what I wanted to do with it. And that's how I kind of like learned to be responsible and being independent. And from then on, my mom was like, you know what, you're earning a salary. I there's no point of me giving you an allowance.
Exactly.
You know, so
you can't have here and here.
You know, I learned, man. As tough as it was, I really learned to stand on my own. But like that kind of like grew me as a person, you know, and hence now me, Psyfo really just is still Psyfo, but it's Psyfo who is the bigger me, who's the person who I can go out and just
hang
do
with,
crazy have, things, you know, and not have to worry about, you know, bazo, what are they gonna think about
exactly.
me and stuff, you know.
Just being that liberated soul.
Yeah. You know, and Psyfo is the more quiet me. You know, it's me when I'm chilling at home, just having a bra with friends, and me just playing my PlayStation.
Actually, sitting next to you, I see that side of Psyfo. I think the quiet guy who would just want his peace and chill. No noise, no anything.
Yeah.
But people at home, our viewers, half the time do not know the difference.
Mm-hmm.
What would be the major difference now between Psyfo, Psyfo, and Ajax on Generations? Because I think
I'll be very honest with you, because I'm just like kind of
a job.
Yeah.
It's a job. The one thing I'd like to tell young people when they go into this industry, when they're looking at it from the outside, I said, just be realistic about it.
Yeah.
It's a job.
It's a job.
What are you going to do the day you don't feel like going to
work?
What are you going to do the day you have to put on makeup and you don't like makeup, or you've got a huge pimple
because
on your face? Just carry on.
Definitely.
The show carries on regardless.
You know what I'm saying?
So you can't be there looking sad and morbid and, oh, my cat died. No, you've got to move on.
Yeah.
So that's where that passion, it's very important, because it feeds into what you do.
Mm-hmm.
It feeds into carrying you through those moments where it's just a little bit of a dip. Particular point, or maybe later I'll remember that story and I'll say, oh, you know, that guy said this and this and this. This is how he dealt with this problem. He'd be my role model in that situation. Mm. He'd be my role model for
at that moment.
Exactly. Yeah. So for me, I believe role models are around us every single day.
Time.
We just need to open ourselves up to learning. Mm. Open it, humble yourself and say, you know what, I don't know it all.
Exactly.
There's somebody out there who might have dealt with this situation slightly differently, who might have had a positive result. Let me just open myself.
Amazing, amazing. I'm sure you must be having some tears in your eyes seeing he can make you laugh, yet at the same time he can make you cry. That's the power of acting, and this young man for sure is going places. Africa, we are blessed to have such talent in Africa. Young, brilliant, I must say, he's full of wisdom. That was amazing, Psyfo.
Thank you very much.
Amazing. Yeah. I mean, the scene with the father, I can't get over it. At the same time, the excitement of Grace is just one thing. But now we've got another character, Psyfo, on stage.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about that part, because that excites you. You become somebody else, and the moves and everything, and the look, because now this is exactly who Psyfo is. Tell me a bit more about that.
You know, like I said at the beginning, I love entertaining people, you know? So in acting, the acting is a different kind of entertainment.
Yeah.
And the being on stage part is the letting go part, you know? That's where I get to enjoy my own creativity, my own birth of creativity, I'd rather say, you know what I'm saying? And it's just, I've just become a completely different person. I love music, you see. It's just, I mean, I was raised in a home where music was just all around me, you know? My mom is an opera singer. And you know, a classical musician, and with her background of music and having to listen to her like either warm up or practice or do whatever she's doing,
it already put that thing,
you know.
And
when I went to school, I was not such a big hip-hop fan. I was raised on kwaito and rock music. I was listening to, I remember how big Arthur was when I was in in primary school, when he was quite big. There were some songs that, like, obviously I can't sing now. But they were quite big.
They were quite
big,
true.
And then, and listening to guys like The Offspring and the Green Day, for instance.
Wow.
You know, I mean, like, listen to those rock bands, and I was like really taken away by them. And I just started falling in love with this whole thing of music making.
Performance.
I bought myself a small computer. I started programming beats on these cheap programs, music programs that you get, you know, where you just take samples and,
throw everything in.
But then I wanted my own, like, I wanted control, you know, I wanted control. So that's when I took up piano.
Do you play?
I could, yeah.
So lovely. We should have gotten a piano.
I'm not a great piano player, but
hey, you play.
I use it to compose, you know, let's put it that way. I use it so I can compose my music, because I like to have my own, I like to have control in everything that I do. So I find, like, some people who sample, it's very limited, you know. I mean, a song is already there, you take it, you sample it, what can you do, you know? It's
already,
the melodies are there,
that's
why I prefer, like, composing a beat from scratch, because it just has so much in it that you can do whatever you want, because it's your composition. But yeah, anyways, music is really my life. You know, I go home, and no matter how sad I am, if I go into my studio, I'll have a great day again. You know?
Well, I have a temptation right now. And if I manage, I'm gonna squeeze your hand to it. I'm going to make sure before you leave this set right now, I find a piano. And you want to give us a little piece. But that we'll discuss with you later on.
Cool.
What was so fascinating about today? Because what I saw since earlier today, it is hard work putting together a music video. You've got the producer, you've got the director, you've got the props, you've got the cast, you've got the crew, and you're the main man. You must be here, must do makeup. You're used to it already, but I think doing music videos,
person, you know, and I got into Generations, and the first thing I told the producers of the show was that I did not want to be portrayed as this musician on the show, because that's what I've already been doing, and I feel like I'll be doing the people at home an injustice by coming on the show and playing
continuing myself.
You know, it's kind of boring. But then they said to me, you know what, as much as we'd like to give you that freedom, but we also have an audience to cater to, you know.
Exactly.
And those are the people who listen to hip-hop, and those are the people who want to aspire to be someone else other than an accountant or lawyer. And so in a way, they kind of brought in an element of a career choice that is quite, it's a reality. I mean, there's entertainment in this country, and it's an industry that's still growing. So they wanted to have some kind of representation of it in the show. And so I had to basically just put my feelings aside and just be an actor and take it on. And they were like, you're already doing it, so I mean, it's going to become so real.
Exactly.
If you bring that character to life, because you already know what it's like being an entertainer, you know what it's like being an artist, a rapper.
It might be at a different level, but it's still the same thing.
But although everything has happened in a parallel, where there are so many similarities, there are big differences at the same time, you know? And one of them is that Usipho is a very, very responsible person compared to what Ajax is
would be at
the time, you know? He's also a very, very young person who's going through life and experiencing all these different things. So there's so much more pressure that is happening for him because the fame happened so quickly.
So young?
No, no, no. I mean, it happened young for me too, but I'm saying for him, it happened so quickly that it was a thing of, he was thrown in the deep end and it just happened, you know, whereas I was in a way gradually brought into it. I never started on a big scale of, you know, of entertainment.
Yeah.
I started in a very, I mean, a young kid show, whereas he was a rapper, you know, so he already came out as a musician.
Mm-hmm.
And it was either people take him serious or they don't.
Yeah. Well, we'll be right back. We're going to be discussing now your music in today's music video. But right now, let's take a close look at some of Ajax's best moment in generations. And right after this, you're going to be getting to see exactly what is it that this young man was up to throughout the day as he was busy with his latest music video. Do enjoy.
In that sort of situation, a woman's power is very, like, undermined, you know. You become this victim.
Yeah.
You become this little toy or this little trophy for this guy. And he gets to play and do whatever, and he calls the shots, you know. So I think, to a large extent, I feel very sorry for her.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like she should just take more power back for herself. To deal with their husbands in a very humble and softer fashion, as opposed to trying to fight him with the gloves and trying to, you know, yell back. You're not going to change anything. It's not going to do anything to him.
She actually never yells. Can
Exactly.
Now Katlego is so different from Dineo, but that particular angle alone, would you say it has taught Katlego a lot? By the time she probably gets there, Dineo may have just put a few things already in place for her.
I think she's taught me a couple of things, patience being one of them, because I really wouldn't have the patience for a man like that. I would not. I don't want to lie. I would really not be able to deal with a Kenneth Mashaba. But she's taught me patience. She's taught me that love is far bigger than what we think it is, than the little boxes we want to put it inside and say, this is life, you know. I've always thought, you know, I'd do something else. I'd maybe become an accountant or a doctor or something else.
Oh, there you are. I have a thing to get to.
Otondochane.
A little surprise, didn't you? What was that? And then they sprang this presentation on us and I forgot.
How convenient for you.
What difference would it have made? Can you
can an excuse and wake up or something?
Shame, man. We do it's a tad.
I swear I know you want Lafis talking Mashaba Media for the next 10 years.
I'm sorry.
You should be sorry. Kwena can say matating. Kwena kaba record a demo.
Bon. And then she'll back off.
After I've made a total fool of myself.
Look at it this way.
Great! I feel much better now. Where's Jackie when I need her?
A part of my life and something that I'm good at, you know.
Exactly.
So let me try it out and see how far it takes me.
Yeah.
So here I am.
Wow. And how many years?
The long journey.
That has taken me. But actually, before you came to Generations now, I want to take you a little bit back to a role that you
professional market with that character, because that character really, really flexes your acting muscles.
Definitely.
You have to, like, know what you're doing when you're playing her. So I mean, you generally don't think there's anybody home, because that's how quiet I can be. You know, I switch off TVs, radios, everything. I can sit literally in silence by myself and when faced with unfamiliar surroundings, they tend to be quite okay.
And to adapt quite easily.
Yes, you know, whereas I just shrink back into myself. I just, I become very quiet, I judge the situation very carefully.
Before you engage,
you know what I'm saying? And I just, okay, this person's like this, this person's like this. Oh, okay.
Seems.
No, it's a lot of work. I mean,
and a budget as well.
Of course. And because, I mean, our industry takes a lot of effort and time, but I love it, which is why I do it, you know?
Yeah.
And it's for me, it's just the final product. That's the biggest thing, you know? It's just the joy that you get out of it.
Exactly.
It's like, wow.
Yeah.
This is, with all the stresses that you've done, it just erases all of that.
You, wow.
You forget about all that and you just think, I've actually brought something to life.
Yeah.
And there it is.
I've heard a lot of quotes with 2009. People saying it's 2009, it's 2009, it's 2000 divine. And I'm saying it is definitely 2000 and yours. You have God on your side more than any other thing. You spoke of energies and the universe being God to you. All I'm saying is that it's a great success. This album, this single, this music video is going to be a hit, not only for South Africa, for Africa and for the world.
Yeah.
You know, because we need this. We need to join hands and sort of chain ourselves together in taking out Africa's talent there, because you're awesome at your age. Any other thing before we leave that you'd like to give to our viewers? Because we've got a whole lot of young people, you know, Psyfo out there. They look at you and they want to get there. They want to do big things, but they do not know how to tap into it.
Okay.
And one of the main things I have realized, people think that the entertainment industry is all about glitz and glamour. There's a whole lot of things that go into it. Tell, just share with our viewers before we go, what are the significant areas to focus on in order to make a success out of yourself, even in the entertainment industry?
Okay, cool. Firstly, I'd just like to say thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to actually speak to Africa, because it's very rare that we have shows like this that connect all Africans. You know, it's always like a country-based television program. So I commend you on that one.
Well, thank you.
And yeah, and can I just, which camera is it? Am I speaking to you? Yeah, I just have to take my glasses off for this one, because I need to connect.
Yeah.
I'd like to say that in life we all have our own purpose, you know, and sometimes you find out about that purpose when you're young, and for some people it happens when they're old, you know. But it really is about you and what you decide for yourself. You know, we all have choices. We have the equal amount of opportunities. But one thing separates all of us, you know, it's perseverance, it's hard work, and it's also belief in yourself. If you don't have faith in what you're doing, if you are not convinced yourself, then you cannot convince anybody else. I've met so many different people in my life, and some people you come across and they have a lot of negative vibes and they're always trying to bring people down. So whatever you do, stay away from those kind of people, because negative energies, I mean, like, it's the same thing as rotten apples. You know, if there's one good apple in a whole bunch of rotten apples, it's gonna be rotten no matter what, you know. So it really is about you trying to run away from that bunch and separating yourself and reaching your destiny. And just really, just no matter what it is, it can be you becoming a scientist. I've grown up not having any real educational background behind me. I mean, I've got a matric, and I look at myself today, and I've always judged myself, and I thought I haven't done big things. But you know, in all honesty, that's not a true reflection of what I have done. You know, you never ever doubt yourself. You know, count your blessings, because that's very, very important. I mean, there's people who have less opportunities than, or rather, less privileges than you, and you'll never know that until you lose those things. So really, just stay true to yourself, respect yourself, and also respect others, you know. You can only make yourself happy. So do that first before you try and make other people happy. But otherwise, I just wanted to say to Africa, thank you very, very much for your support. I know that you watch Generations all the time, and it may not be just for me, or it may not be just for Karabo, but the fact that you are supporting African shows is what matters to me as an artist. And yeah, man, we must all just try and build Africa, man. I know, like, the world is always looking at us like as the continent that has like all these diseases, and but listen, we are such a blessed continent. Why would we have such and really, I mean, we don't have all these earthquakes that are happening all around. And I spoke earlier on about things like karma, you know, and all these natural disasters that are happening outside of our continent. You know, and that's because we are a blessed country. I mean, excuse me, a blessed continent. It's really up to you to try and elevate yourself and stop thinking about what CNN is bringing us, and just keep Africa alive, man. Yeah.
You're bringing me to tears. And I must say that you're definitely full of wisdom. And you're really, really touching my heart. I mean, saying close, you're just touching on very, very critical issues and really sending that message home. Wishing all of the best, my brother, and we love you. We're so proud of you. Well, that is all we have for you today. I'm quite touched. I'm sure you'll agree with me. Psyfo is not just a man on stage singing. He's not just Ajax on Generation. He's an amazing, amazing young African man with lots and lots of possibilities. He's going places, not for himself only, Africa for all of us, because our success in South Africa is our success in the continent, and definitely we can conquer the world right here in the rich soil of Africa. Until we meet again on another exciting and life-changing episode of Soul Screen Profiles, I'm Moleboheng Matli. We love you. Ciao.
We have, unfortunately, we're in a crisis now with the whole world recession, you know. Economically, things aren't great. And in the music industry, I mean, rather in the entertainment industry, it was never great. Well, in our country, that is, you know, the actors and musicians and just artists have really suffered when it comes to being paid. I mean, we get paid the least, and we still get taxed so much, you know, and it really demotivates a person.
A whole lot,
you know,
of people,
you think, why am I really doing this? You know, I put so much, I'm
effort
at work at
7
o'clock
this.
In the morning, and I go 7 o'clock at night, I leave home, I mean, for home, and I get home, and it's 8 o'clock, I'm supposed to have dinner, then I'm supposed to learn my lines for tomorrow. So you really, you know what I mean? And which is why we need a lot of support for our own, this industry. And being like producing a video like this, really.
Because when people see a music video on television, it's all glamorous, it looks good, but there's actually so much work behind, a bit different. At the same time, exciting. Tell me about the actual process of one shooting a music video. Well, once again, I'm seated comfortably in the Generation Studios, actually in their lounge. This time, I'm with one of the loved youngest, and I should say again, very beautiful, Katlego Danke, better known as Dinoma Shaba. Those two different characters are definitely something we will understand better by the end of this chat. Katlego, hi.
Hi.
Welcome to Soul Screen.
Thank you very much.
I wasn't actually sure whether I should say Katlego Dineo, because I rhyme better with Dineo.
I work better with Katlego.
Because actually now seated with you, I'm not seeing Dineo at all.
No.
I'm very surprised.
Not at all. I guess that's why we're very different in a lot of ways.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're different people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, now tell me about Katlego Danke. Who is she? Where is she from? What is she really, really all about?
Sure. I grew up, I'd say, mostly in the Northwest. So I've been sort of not in the arts per se. I did it at school. Everybody knows I used to be in plays. I used to sing a lot. I used to do all of those things. Since like age of five, I used to dance a lot. But it was never a career option for me. I never thought of it as a career. Well, thank you. My dad would love to hear that. But yes, I always thought, you know, maybe I might do something else, something completely different. So this came as a surprise a little while later when I got to varsity and I thought, what should I do?
Yeah.
And I thought, well, let me do something I enjoy doing, something that's always been there. It's always been.
Has it been? Here you are.
It has been since 2002. I've been acting professionally. Before that, I did a four-year degree at UCT. So, that's...
You did. That was quite interesting. When I look at Dineo and I look at how you exited that particular role, it must have been quite challenging. Was it challenging for you to play that role back then at Scandal?
Backstage. Yes. You know, that role was, sure, she was unprecedented. She was...
Certainly.
...in a world of her own,
you
know? So I enjoyed playing her. I think she was a bit of a challenge, which was good. It was very good for me to enter into the fact that I got to...
But now tell me about Katlego and the major differences she would have with any other character she must portray on television and the actual her.
Wow, that's
because
a good question.
Because you seem very quiet, laid back.
I'm a very quiet person.
I would say shy, but given your acting skills, no.
I tend to be. Yeah. I can be very shy, especially in an environment where I don't know a lot of people. People tend to think, oh, she's being funny, you know, she doesn't want to speak to us, what. But it's just that I'm naturally a very quiet person. If I'm in the house, be okay.
Enjoy you.
Yes, enjoy my own space.
Please help me enjoy you.
No, try that. It works, I promise you. So generally, I tend to be a very quiet person, which I think is different from most of the roles I play. Because most of them are very... Well, they're out there kind of people, you know, they engage with people, They're not shy.
Well, definitely at Soul Screen, we feel honored because you accepted the invitation first time around.
No, it's an absolute pleasure.
Having left, you know, varsity and any other thing you may have wanted to do back then up till now, any regrets in terms of stepping into the industry, any other thing you'd wish to do outside career that you're currently pursuing?
I don't have regrets per se, because I always say there's always opportunities in life, and there's always stuff you can do.
Yeah.
For me, there's no closed door. There's no door that I've closed that doesn't exist for me anymore. So I'm still continuing on that journey of discovering who I am, where I'd like to go, how I can stretch myself, how I can grow, and all the mountains that I can conquer.
Yeah.
So for me, it's that. It's that constant seeking to push yourself beyond the boundaries that you've already created, you know, and the little world that you know now. How much bigger can you make that? How much further can you go? So yeah, I'd like to do a lot of things. At the moment, acting in movies would be a passion of mine.
Lovely.
Directing would definitely be a passion for theater and for stage. And producing. I'd like to produce movies as well.
So you're into films, actually?
I'm into film and TV. I'd say producing television television production as well. Yeah.
Well, let's take a look at that clip. Right now, we're going to be taking a close look at the clip of Dineo Mashaba and Anne
De Villiers
and a whole lot of more things that she has done actually on Generations. She's an amazing actress, very humble in real character. It is shocking, but do enjoy the clips of Dineo Mashaba. Well, definitely you'll agree with me. What you've just seen is completely different from what we see now. Tell me, you know, more about actually your role as Ken's wife, because that is like the biggest thing ever, you know, being a young wife, married to this rich man, he's possessive, he's all that, but you're fighting back, you know, and I think we've got a lot of realities like that. How do you relate to that character of Udineo at that, in that context?
Sometimes I feel sorry for her because I think
that's one thing most women we should learn, hey?
Yes. You know, funny enough, I ran into this old lady the one time in a shop, and she came up to me and she said, you know, well done, you know, I think Danelle's a role model for other women and wives especially. I said, what? I was like, this woman is mad. There's no such thing. She can't be a role model.
Not with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Do you know what I'm saying? So I said to her, but what are you talking about? Yeah. And she says, no, do you understand that she teaches women how do you know what I'm saying?
Way.
No. Love has got lots of definitions. And the nice thing about it is you define love for yourself.
Wow.
So you sit there and you say, well, I love this person. And it's because of X, Y, and Z. And we click and, you know, because we don't understand why and how she loves Kenneth, but she does.
She really does.
Do you know what I'm saying? She really does. It's not an act. She does love him. We might not understand it. We might not accept it. And we might not think it's right.
Yeah, or
but
even
she does.
Real.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But she does. On some level, she does love this monster of a man who abuses her from time to time.
But you're definitely not pretending that Generations isn't happening, because it's an awesome opportunity. I'm saying I look at it as a platform that has really, really grown you. You've always been stunning. We knew you back then. But when you now came as Dineo, we got to know the other side of Katlego. I say now because you're portraying this grown, matured woman, which is actually not very far. The actual challenges behind being a soap star, because there should be challenges here and there.
There's always challenges. Like in any other job, there's always challenges. And people, unfortunately, see only one side of our job. They see the glitz. They see the glam. They see us on the red carpet. They see us here in magazines and on TV. And they're like, wow, what a fantastic life. The truth is, it's not.
Oh,
okay?
Exactly.
You wake up at 6:30 in the morning. You don't feel like you want to go to work. You're tired. You want to get that little bit extra sleep, you know? But it's a job.
It is a job.
It's a job.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's a job. There are days when you don't want to do it. You don't feel like looking fabulous and pretty and putting on makeup. Exactly.
And go your way.
Exactly. So there are days, just like anybody else, you're just like, I wish I didn't have to do this today.
Yeah.
Can I postpone? But it's
like, I don't want anything. I just want to be me.
Exactly. Oh, you've got this huge pimple, and they're like, we're going to do a shoot today. And there you are with this huge pimple.
Yeah.
What do you do?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so you have to find reserves of passion, reserves of the reasons why you're doing this.
The actual reasons.
Exactly.
So would you say being in the entertainment industry actually has got a lot more to do with passion than actually just the love for it.
Because you have to be passionate.
There's a whole lot more that goes behind the scenes than the love for it or the money for that matter.
True. I think you have to be passionate about it, especially in this country, because I don't think there's particularly a lot of money
definitely
in the entertainment industry in South Africa. So you have to be passionate about it. I always say it's like being a doctor or a teacher or a lawyer. It's a calling.
Yeah.
It's not something you decide to do.
Yeah.
You've got to be called to do it. And fortunately or unfortunately, you can see when somebody's been called to do the job or when somebody's just doing the job because
for the sake of fame
or because they think there's money in it or because they think, or whatever reason. You know.
Any other reason out there.
You can see it. You can. I can definitely pick out any actor. I can switch on the TV and say, ah, this one, there's no passion behind there. They're doing this job for other reasons.
Yeah.
You know, so I'd say be passionate about it. It helps. It helps in the long run. It helps on the days where things aren't really going that great. You're forgetting lines. Your brain isn't coming together like it wants
because
to.
Because you're a normal person at the same time dealing with real issues of your life.
Yes.
At normal ground.
Yes. Yeah. You know, it helps on the days where something bad has happened in your life and you have to pull it aside. So that you can focus on what it is you need to do, because the show...
Talking about that, Katlego, as well, how important is purpose? You know, when you started earlier on, you said something so important that you believe it's all about calling. And I believe calling goes hand in hand with purpose. Do you consider this acting to be your purpose? Because this is the way in which you can reach out to people. This is the best way you can portray the God in you and take out the gift in you for people to receive it and glorify God with it.
Absolutely. I think when you are living your life within your calling, within where you're supposed to be, where you're meant to be in your life, it then fulfills your purpose.
Wow.
It then translates to other people as a blessing. They receive it.
Yeah.
And people will say to you, wow, you know what you're doing? I like what you're doing. And it touched me in this way and that way and that way and that way. You might not think it's doing anything. You might go home and say, oh, you know, I just did my job. I don't know what these people are talking about. You know, but when it's on that level, when it's on that spiritual level, that higher level, there's nothing, you can't stop it. It's going to reach people. It's going to touch people. It's going to affect people in a way that you don't even know or understand, you know. So I think, yes, in a way, this has become my purpose. This acting has fulfilled my purpose on earth, you know, in my life.
And tell me finally, what keeps Katlego inspired? You're so motivated. I mean, I love the fact that you are saying that there's a whole lot of negativity, there's a whole lot of challenges, but you have found yourself. You know who you are. You are standing on solid ground. Come whatever may, you have found Katlego. What keeps you motivated? A role model? Any positive instiller in Katlego's life?
I think for me, it's the ability to keep growing and the ability to keep listening. I don't have a role model. I don't believe in role models because I believe I can learn from anybody. I can be speaking to the guy on the side of the road and he can share with me a story that will help me in my life at that
point.
Yes, let me open myself and hear what they have to say and maybe I might just grow and learn from it.
Wow.
So for me, that's how I've managed to keep inspiring myself, because I look around and I say, hey, so-and-so has learned this and they're doing this better. Maybe I can learn that. Pick up from that.
You're open-minded, always ready to learn.
Exactly.
Well, Katlego, wishing you all of the best. Thank you so much. I've had fun.
Thank
you. I'm wishing you all of the best towards generations. And yes, my eye is definitely on the rail soon. But we actually forgot to talk about the men in Africa, because you're not only the envy of African women. You definitely, I don't know which word to use, but I know African men definitely are fans. And I'll give you the honor, you know, to actually close this. Give a word to our men out there in Africa and our women, of course.
Well, to all the men out there, I'd say I hope you guys find the love that you deserve. And to honor your women every day, because women, that's what they love. They love attention and they love to be honored. So honor your woman and she will honor you right back. To all the women in the world, I'd say, have the pride in your step, the swing in your hip, like Maya Angelou says. Keep that going. That will work for you wonders.
Well, I would have added on that. She has said a mouthful. Honor your woman, men of Africa. And women, do what with your hip?
So keep the swing in your hip.
Keep the swinging of the hip until we meet again on another exciting profiling of our stars in South Africa. Stay blessed.